I will introduce myself. I am Airport Police Lieutenant Jess Dugusin of the Airport Police Department. And today, my assignment is to lecture on the fundamentals of criminal investigation. So ang topic natin ngayon is napaka importante sa larangan ng law enforcement. So, para po sa iba na nagtataka, ano po ba yung airport police? Ito po yung law enforcement arm ng Manila International Airport Authority. Hindi po kami under ng Philippine National Police sapagkat sila po ay under ng DILG. Mas malawak po ang kanilang sakop. Kami po ay isang maliit na sangay ng law enforcement dito sa paliparan ng NAIA. Magpakagayon pa man, dito po sa NAIA, mayroon siyang sariling police authority or police arm who enforces the law, maintain peace and order, and investigate crimes. So dito po, bilang criminologist, masaya ko pong pinabalita sa inyo na na-perform ko, na-apply po natin yung napag-aralan natin sa criminology. Isa po akong criminologist since 2002. And 17 years in the service na po ako dito sa Airport Police Department. At kasalukuyan po ay may rank po ako na Airport Police Lieutenant. So we can now start. Marami na pong nanonood sa atin. Kumusta po kayo? We will now formally start our discussion on criminal or the fundamentals of criminal investigation. But before anything else, ang magiging mode of lecture po natin is parang yung classroom. Mahilig po kasi ako magsulat, so join me. Imagine po ninyo na sa isang classroom kayo at nandun yung strictong professor nyo. Although this is an online, we will make it as lively as we can. Okay. Okay. Ulitin natin ulit. Para sa mga bagong viewers, sabi natin our topic is all about criminal investigation. Criminal investigation is a combination of different skills and knowledge. Being a criminal investigator, you must have that first, you must have that yung sinasabi na legal knowledge. Okay. Why legal knowledge? Nung tayo ay nag-aaral ng kriminolohiya, tinuruan tayo ng criminal law. Book 1 and Book 2. Alam natin yung mga elements of crime. Alam natin yung fundamental principles ng crimes. Okay? Tinuruan tayo ng criminal procedure. Alam natin yung iba't ibang procedure. Alam natin yung procedure on arrest, procedure on preliminary investigation, procedure on bail, procedure on arraignment, trial, judgment, up to search and seizure. Then, tinuruan din tayo ng knowledge on criminal evidence. Anong tinuro sa atin? Tinuro tayo, what is evidence? When can an evidence be inadmissible in court? Kailan ba siya masasabing relevant? Competent? So, lahat yon pinaghaluhalong legal knowledge ng isang criminologist na ma-apply niya sa pagiging CI or criminal investigator. Okay, how about yung tinatawag na technical knowledge? Okay. Technical skill and knowledge. Ano tong technical skill and knowledge na to? Tinuruan tayo ng criminalistics, di ba? Mga forensic sciences, katulad ng dactyloscopy. Okay? Dactyloscopy. Tinuruan din tayo ng polygraphy. tinuruan tayo ng ballistics and many more. Ito ang gagamiting technical skill and knowledge ng isang criminal investigator. At ano pa? Pag ikaw ay criminal investigator, nalalagay ka sa mga sitwasyon na kailangan mong depensa ng sarili mo, kailangan mong manghuli, kailangan mong umaresto, anong gagamitin mo? Tinuruan tayo ng tactical skills. Okay. Tinuruan tayo ng martial arts or yung tinatawag na depta or defensive tactics. Okay. Tinuruan tayo ng unarmed self-defense or yung tinatawag na armed self-defense, paggamit ng baril, paggamit ng armis. Okay. At lahat yan ay nakakatulong sa isang magaling na criminal investigator. Kasi sa pagiging criminal investigator, nakataya dito ang buhay mo. This is a vocation. This is a calling. Bakit? Kung ikaw ay criminal investigator, ang problema ng iba, pinoproblema mo. So, ganun ang hirap ng pagiging criminal investigator. Okay? So much with this as an introduction. Gusto ko lang iparamdam sa inyo na kakaiba ang kurso natin. Kakaiba ang kurso natin, criminology. Kakaiba yan. Pwede natin ipagmalakihan kahit saan. Okay? Okay, sorry. Okay. So, you must be proud being a criminology graduate, being a criminology student, and much more kung kayo ay criminologist na. So, sa mga hindi pa criminologist dito, I want to inspire you. Kailangan pagdating ng araw maging criminologist kayo. Kailangan pag naging criminologist kayo, i-apply nyo yan sa kahit anong paraan, kailangan makapasok kayo. Kung gusto nyo maging police, gusto nyo maging law enforcers, other law enforcement agencies, or pumasok sa other public safety agencies ng ating government, gamitin ninyo yan. That is something to be proud of, being a criminologist and being a criminology graduate. So, naka-back front po yung camera natin, hindi ko na babasa yung mga comments ninyo. So, just go with me. Lecture type, mamaya mag-Q&A tayo sa ating laptop. Okay. I-review mo natin. Pag ikaw ay criminologist, ikaw ay criminal investigator, dapat marunong ka sa legal knowledge. Dapat alam mo, what is crime? Dapat kahit wala kang binabasa, alam mo ang crime. Dapat sa utak mo, andun na yung definition of crime. Bakit? Yan ang trabaho mo. To investigate crime. Okay, what is crime? Crime is an act or mission punishable by law, forbidding or commanding it. Ang gandang i-recite, di ba? Okay. Then what is criminal law? Tanongin na, bakit may crime? Because there is criminal law which punishes that act or omission. What is criminal law? Dapat bilang criminologist, bilang criminal investigator, alam mo, what is criminal law? Criminal law is that branch or division of public law which defines crime, threats of their nature, and provides for their punishment. Ganun kasimple. Okay? Tinong, huy, sa criminal? Yan, mga tanong na yan. Pwede mo na sagutin. Depende yan. Sa legal point of view at sa criminological point of view. Yan. E paano ba? What is... Who is a criminal in a legal point of view? Sasagutin ka ng criminologist. You can be considered criminal if you are being processed with all the pillars of the Philippine criminal justice system. Pag nadaanan mo lahat yung pillars ng criminal justice system, that's the time na pwede kang tawaging criminal. Pero in a criminological point of view, The moment you commit an act or omission, you are already considered criminal. Okay? Eh sir, pagka ba may nakita ako na nanaksak ng tao, criminal na ba siya? Yes, in a criminological point of view. Pero not in a legal point of view. Kaya nga, ang sabi natin kanina, we must have that legal knowledge. Okay? Legal knowledge. And, kasabay ng legal knowledge na to, dapat mayroon tayong understanding sa ating tinatawag na five pillars of the Philippine criminal justice system. Okay. Okay, five pillars of the Philippine criminal justice system. Napakasimple yan sa inyo. Okay, the first pillar, ito yung tinatawag na law enforcement pillar. Okay. Law enforcement pillar, it is not necessary. Tanggalin natin sa ating paniniwala na yung law enforcement pillar ay solely yung mga member ng Philippine National Police, no? Maraming law enforcement agencies dito sa ating bansa performing law enforcement functions. Okay, performing police functions. Okay, so law enforcement pillar, mayroon dyan PNP, NBI, PDEA, or kagaya sa amin, may airport police. So gusto lang natin maliwanagan na yung law enforcement pillar pala, ito ay ahensya ng pamahalaan task to maintain peace and order, na hindi lang kuhawak ng isang institusyon. Okay? The second pillar, sino yan? Ito yung prosecution pillar. Prosecution. Okay. Sa mundo ng criminality, pag ang isang tao ay gumawa ng krimen, andyan yung police, siya ang manghuhuli dun sa gumawa. Okay. Sa law enforcement, ang tawag dun sa huliin ay suspect. Okay. Suspect. Pag yung suspect na yon ay nahuli without warrant at i-undergo siya ng tinatawag na inquest proceeding, okay, dadalhin siya sa prosecution, itong suspect na to ay magiging, ang tawag sa kanya ay literal respondent. Okay? Then here comes yung respondent na yan, if there is a probable cause na may ginawa siya at kakasuhan siya sa ating korte via information na gagawin ng ating mga prosecutors. Yung information, this is an accusation in writing charging a person with an offense and filed with the court. Itong respondent na to, pagdating sa court pillar, ay magiging, ang tawag sa kanya? Accused. Okay. Pag yung court na yan nag-conduct ng trial at napatunayan beyond a reasonable doubt na yung suspect na to, yung naging respondent natin sa prosecution, yung accused ay nagkasala, siya ay i-convict at ipapataw sa kanya yung impossible penalty. Itong accused na to, pagdating niya sa court pillar, which is correction, ang magiging tawag sa kanya ngayon ay ano? Convicted offender. Convicted na siya. Okay, convicted offender. Okay, convicted offender. Bakit? Convicted na siya. So ipapasok na siya sa correctional institution. How if that convicted offender, na-serve na niya yung sentence niya at kailangan na siyang lumabas, ibabalik na siya sa ikalimang pilar at yon ay tinatawag na ano? Community pilar. Okay, community. Pag itong convicted offender na balik sa community, ang magiging tawag na sa kanya ay ano? Tatawagin na siyang ex-convict. Babalik siya sa community via yung tinatawag na reintegration. Okay, question. Sir, bakit mo dinidiscuss yan? Okay, this is a good preliminary para maintindihan ninyo yung duties and responsibilities ng isang criminal investigator. Kasi napaka-importante yung duties niya. Without that criminal investigator who belongs to the law enforcement pillar, hindi mo maitatawid yung tao from the law enforcement pillar to prosecution to court hanggang mapunta sa correction. Bakit? Napaka-importante ng role ng criminal investigator. Okay, pag criminal investigator ka, kaya nga tinawag na initiator of the criminal justice system ang law enforcement. Ang CI, tandaan natin, ang criminal investigator, belong to the law enforcement pillar. At bilang criminal investigator, gagamitin niya yung tatlong knowledge na dinidiscuss natin. Legal, technical, and tactical. Okay, bakit? Para mag-imbestiga siya ng crime. Alam natin na ang crime is an act or mission punishable by law. Okay. At ang crime na to ay dahil mayroon tayong tinatawag na criminal law. Okay. And that criminal law is that branch or division of public law which defines crime, treats of their nature, and provides for their punishment. Okay, para maintindihan natin itong criminal law, itong crime na to, this is a generic term, pero nahati ito sa tatlo. Okay? Mayroon tinatawag na felony, offense, at saka, ano yung pangatlo na? Violation ng mga city ordinance? Felony, offense, at saka, magpatulong tayo. Ano na yun, Adrin? Felony, offense, at saka?
Infraction.
Okay, sorry. Infraction. Okay, anong pagkakaiba nitong tatlo? Pag sinabing felony, it is violation of the revised penal code. Pag sinabing offense, violation ng mga special penal laws. Pag infraction, ito yung violation ng mga city or municipal ordinances. Okay. Either kahit saan sa mga to, itong tatlo na to, pag may krimen nangyari, kailangan ng technical knowledge ng criminal investigator. Yan. Yan papasok. Okay. So, pupunta na tayo sa criminal investigation. So, maliwanag? Ganun ka-importante ang knowledge ng isang criminal investigator na nakukuha lamang pag nag-aral ka ng criminolohiya or criminology. Okay. Punta na natin ang definition ng criminal investigation. Okay. Ano ba yung tinatawag na criminal investigation? Okay. Criminal investigation. Ano ba yan, sir? Sabi niya, it is an art which deals with the identity of the criminal offender. Okay. Art daw yan, art. Sir, question. Bakit siya art? Hindi ba siya science? Kaya mamaya malalaman natin. Kung yan ba ay art, yan ba ay science? But as to definition provided for by books, criminology books, sabi nila, it is an art. Art daw. Which deals with the, number one, identity of criminal offender. Itong criminal offender na to, ito yung suspect natin. Okay, suspect. Number two, they deal with the location of the whereabout of that suspect location. I-identify niya, ilo-locate niya, at ano yung pangatlo? It deals with the providing of evidence of his guilt. Okay. Okay. So, in short, ganito. Pag criminal investigator ka, mayroon kang tatlong responsibilidad. Una, is to identify. Sasagutin mo yung unang tanong na who? Sino ang gumawa? Sino ang suspect? Okay. Who? Or whom? Sino ang biktima? Lahat sasagutin mo yan. Sino yung possible witnesses? Basta sino? Who? The next, pag na-identify mo na yung suspect, ang pangalawa mong gagawin or dapat mong gawin is to locate. Okay. Locate or trace the whereabout. Nasaan itong suspect na to? So, sasagutin mo kung where. Saan natin makikita itong suspect na to? Ilo-locate natin siya. Bakit? Para hulihin natin siya. Sa paanong paraan? Pagpasok pa sa reglementary period, hulihin natin siya basta pasok sa tinatawag na warrantless arrest. Pero paglampas na at hindi na pwedeng arestuhin without warrant, ang kailangan gawin natin is i-file natin yung kaso through regular filing until such time mapalabasan siya ng tinatawag na warrant of arrest. Okay, so ilolocate natin siya. Ano yung pinaka-importante? Para hindi masayang yung ginawang pag-identify, hindi masayang yung ginawang pag-locate, kailangan mag-provide tayo ng evidence. Okay. Ebidensya. Ebidensya na nagpapatunay na itong suspect na to ay may kasalanan. It's a proof beyond reasonable doubt. Pag nagawa lahat ng investigador ito, identify, locate, and provide evidence, that's the essence of criminal investigation. Okay. So, we will now have a specific discussion on the theoretical aspect ng criminal investigation. Eh, sir, lahat ba ng police investigator? Yan ang question natin. Lahat ba ng police investigator? No. Lahat ba ng law enforcer investigator? No. Ang pagiging investigator ay piling-pili. Bakit? May mga katangian ang mga investigador na dapat taglay niya. Hindi lang basta-basta maging investigator. Okay. Ngayon, sir, ano ba yung mga katangian na yan? Marami. Sa-isahin natin. Okay, qualities of an investigator. Papag-usapan natin yung mga qualities. Paano ka maging isang magaling na criminal investigator? Okay. Sa aking experience as a criminal investigator here at NAIA, ang unang-una na quality na kailangan mayroon ang isang investigador ay yung tinatawag na passion. Passion for criminal investigation. Ibig sabihin, mahal mo yung pag-iimbestiga. Kaya mong ialay ang buhay mo dyan. Kaya mong magpakasakit in the name of criminal investigation. Bakit? alam mong delikado yan. Pag criminal investigator ka, laban ka sa lahat. Kalaban mo, unang-una, yung mga kriminal. Okay? Kalaban mo, yung mga kaibigan ng kriminal. Kalaban mo, yung mga pumoprotekta sa kriminal. So, ganun kahirap ang criminal investigation. Kung wala kang passion o pagmamahal sa iyong trabaho, hindi ka pwede maging investigador. Okay. Number two, kung gusto mong maging investigador, dapat maging honest ka. Honest. Ano ibig sabihin yan? Hindi pwede rito yung taong sinungaling. Sinungaling sa kapwa at sinungaling sa sarili. Dapat nasa iyo yung tinatawag na truthfulness. Totoo ka sa iyong sarili. Hindi ka bias. Okay? Kasi kung bias ka, sinungaling ka sa iyong sarili, hindi ka pwedeng maging investigador. Okay? Pangatlo, kailangan may endurance ka. Ang pagiging criminal investigator ay mahirap. It is very tiresome. Nakakapagod. Kasi pag may iniimbestigahan kang krimen, magpupuyat ka, magpapakahirap ka, okay? Pakahirap ka, physically and mentally. Physically, susundan mo, talagang mag-research ka, hindi ka titigil hanggat hindi nasusolve yung kaso. So dapat, mayroon kang tinatawag na endurance. Ang endurance is a physical at saka mental stability. Okay. Mapagmahal ka nga sa trabaho mo, honest ka nga, pero nung binigyan ka ng kaso, mahina ang iyong katawan, okay? Physically, mahina ang iyong isip, nung tinakot ka, natakot ka na, ang hirap naman ito, sumuko ka na, useless ka. Okay. Then, mayroong tinatawag na pinaka-importante. Dapat you have the power of observation and description. Ano yung power of observation and description na yan? Bilang isang investigador, lahat na nakikita mo, dapat kaya mong itanim sa utak mo. Ibig sabihin, parang nire-record mo yan. Dahil lahat na nakikita mo habang nag-iimbestiga ka, magagamit mo sa pag-solve ng kaso. Okay? Then, as a quality of investigator, you must have that sense of fairness and fair play. Ibig sabihin, wala kang pinapanigan. Hindi porke mayaman yan siyang papanigan mo, hindi porke maganda yan siyang papanigan mo. Dapat fair ka lang, huwag kang bias. Dahil pag naging bias ka, sira ang pagiging investigador mo. Hindi ka dapat maging investigador. Then, isa pa, pag investigador ka, dapat marunong kang mag-artista. Ano ibig sabihin nito? Sa pagiging investigador, iba't ibang klase ng tao ang kausap mo. Makikipag-usap ka sa mga may posisyon, mayayaman, edukado. Makikipag-usap ka sa mga hindi nakatapos ng pag-aaral, nasa baba ng lipunan. So, dapat ikaw na investigador, mayroon kang acting ability. Makikipag-usap ka sa mga mababait, mayayabang, matatapang. So, dapat kaya mong i-blend yung sarili mo sa kanila. Okay. So, that's the some of the qualities of a good criminal investigator. Dapat mayroon kang passion, honest ka, may endurance ka, may power of observation ka and description, and mayroon kang acting ability. Aside from being intelligent, being knowledgeable with law, having technical knowledge, having courage, okay, yun yung qualities of being an investigator. So gusto lang natin ipakita na hindi ganun kadali ang magiging criminal investigator. Okay. So ulitin natin. There are three objectives of criminal investigation. Okay. Sabihin natin, una, is concerned with the identity of the criminal. Okay. Number two, he is concerned with the location of the criminal. And number three, he is concerned with the production of evidence to prove the guilt of that criminal or suspect. Okay, so tatlo yan. Identification of the criminal, location of the criminal, at saka providing of evidence to prove his guilt. Yan yung objectives of criminal investigation. Objectives of CI. Tanda natin yan, lumalabas sa board exam yan. Objectives of criminal investigation. Okay, para magkaroon tayo ng kwan, sabihin mo ILP. Identification, location, and providing of evidence to prove his guilt. Okay. What kind of evidence? An evidence that is competent and relevant. Ano ibig sabihin pag competent? Sa criminal evidence? Pag sinabing ang evidence is competent, ibig sabihin, it is not excluded by law. Yung ebidensya mo ba yan ay product of hearsay? Okay. How about relevance? Dapat may connection siya doon sa krimeng iniimbestigan mo. So, combination of relevancy and competency. Okay. That's the objectives of criminal investigation. Mayroon akong tinitignan dito para at least maging guide sa paglelecture natin. Okay? So, i-review natin. Sabi natin kanina, ang isang criminal investigator ay nagsisilbi siya sa law enforcement pillar. Siya ang mag-i-initiate ng action. Siya ang aresto, magpo-proseso, at huhuli, at mag-provide ng ebidensya laban dun sa suspect. Okay. Para yung suspect na yan ay may proseso from law enforcement pillar, pupunta sa prosecution pillar hanggang maisampa yung kaso sa kanya sa court pillar, at pag na-convict na siya, pagdudusahan niya yung kanyang ginawa sa correction pillar until such time ma-serve niya yung sentence niya at lalabas siya at babalik siya sa community pillar. So, just a little review of the Philippine criminal justice system. Kailangan natin kasi i-correlate yung trabaho ng criminal investigator sa pillars of the criminal justice system plus yung mga knowledge na nakuha natin noong nag-aaral pa tayo sa criminology. Okay. Ngayon, siguro familiar ka rito yung tinatawag na three, okay, eyes of criminal investigation. What are the three eyes of criminal investigation? Halimbawa, nasa classroom kayo, i-recite nyo. Ano yung first eye? Ano yung second eye? Ano yung third eye? Okay. Sir, ang number one na eye is information. Okay, information. Ano information na yan? Okay. Number two ay yung tinatawag na interview or interrogation. Sir, ano yung interview interrogation na yan? Mamaya malalaman natin. Ano yung pangatlong ay? Pangatlo. Ito na yung tinatawag na instrumentation. Okay? So, ito yung mga three eyes of criminal investigation. The three eyes of criminal investigation. Okay, number one, information. Mamaya isa-isahin natin yan. Number two, interview or interrogation. Anong pinagkaiba ng dalawa na yan? Parehas lang ba sila? And number three, yung tinatawag na instrumentation. Sir, marami bang instrument yan? Marami. Malalaman natin mamaya. Okay. So, dapat, pag sinabing three eyes, dapat alam na niya, information, interview, interrogation, at saka instrumentation. Ito yung tools. Tinatawag na tools of CI, criminal investigation. Pag sinabing tools, yan yung gagamitin ng criminal investigator para doon sa tatlong objectives. Identification of the criminal offender or suspect, location, locating or tracing of the criminal offender, at saka yung providing of evidence to prove his guilt. Yun ang gagamitin niya. Okay, ito yung gagamitin niya para matupad yung three objectives. Ano yung three objectives na yan? Ito yung ILP. Identification, yung location, at saka providing of evidence. So nakikita na ninyo yung connection ng three eyes sa three objectives ng criminal investigation. Ito yung gagamitin mo para ma-attain mo ang mga ito. Okay. Kailangan magkaroon ka ng information. And what is that information? Ano ba yung information, sir? Okay, let us tackle what is information. Ano ba yung information na yan? Information. Okay. Sa board naman, kailangan ng keyword. Keyword lang yan sa board. Okay. Sabi, information is the knowledge. Okay. Knowledge acquired and gathered by the criminal investigator from other person. Yung CI, criminal investigator, okay, knowledge yan. Impormasyon na nakukuha sa ibang tao. Yun yun. Maraming klase ng impormasyon as to different books. Okay, mayroon tayong three kinds of information pertaining to criminal offenders or suspect. Okay. Mayroong yung knowledge na yan ay pwedeng, o yung information na yan ay pwedeng makuha sa tinatawag na regular sources. Okay, regular sources. Yan yung una. Regular sources. Itong information na to pwede makuha via regular sources. An example niyan, kung yung information na yan, yung tao na yan ay mayroon ng file sa mga police station, sa NBI, sa PNP, or any other law enforcement agency, ang tao doon, regular sources. Regular lang yan. Okay. Nakuha mo sa regular na pamamaraan. Okay. Pero pwede ka rin kumuha ng impormasyon sa paanong paraan? Sa pamamagitan ng cultivated sources. Ano itong cultivated sources? Okay. Yan na natin ginagamit yung mga informant at informers. Mga informant natin or mga informers. Sa criminology, alam niyo pagkakaiba ng informant sa informers. Pag sinabing informant, nagbibigay siya ng impormasyon na hindi kailangan siyang bayaran o bigyan ng kapalit. Pero pag sinabing informer, kailangan bayaran mo siya. Paid yan. Yung binibigay niyang impormasyon, may bayad yan. So, si itong dalawa, informant or informers, ang tawag sa kanila ay cultivated sources. Itong informant, pwedeng kaibigan ng pulis yan. Okay, dahil na gawa ng pulis na maganda, para makabawi siya, bibigyan niya ng information. Or itong informant, pwedeng civic, spirited person. Ibig sabihin, may concern siya. For example, may nangyaring krimen. Para makatulong ako, dahil ako isang mabuting mamamayan ng Pilipinas, kailangan magbigay ako ng impormasyon na alam ko para masolve na lang yung iniimbestigahang krimen. Okay, informant yan. Mamaya, malalaman natin yung iba't ibang klase ng informant pagdating natin sa next topic natin. Okay, next. Mayroon din tinatawag na information from grapevine. Anong grapevine? Grapevine sources. Ano itong grapevine sources? Yan yung mundo ng mga kriminal. Grapevine sources. Okay. Yun yung mga members of the underworld na tinatawag. Pwede kang kumuha ng impormasyon sa mga prisoner. Sa mga ex-convict. Yan. Ang tawag dyan is from grapevine sources. So may tatlong sources, primary sources ng information, from regular sources, from cultivated sources, and from grapevine sources. So i-memorize natin yan, lumalabas sa board exam yan. Regular sources, from regular source, from police files, from other government agencies, records, okay? Regular sources yan. Hindi mo na kailangan mag-cultivate ng tao para magbigay, mag-inform sa'yo, or hindi mo na kailangan magbayad because they are from regular sources. As compared to cultivated source, kailangan mo makipagkaibigan, okay? Kailangan mo magbayad para makakuha ka ng impormasyon. Sa grapevine sources naman, kailangan mo maging kaibigan, yung mga bilanggo o yung mga dating ex-convict, bakit? Doon ka kukuha ng impormasyon. Okay. So, don't forget the three sources of information. Okay. So, yung flow ng ating discussion ngayon, nasa first eye na tayo ng criminal investigation. Nasa information pa lang tayo. Nasabi natin, may tatlong sources. Regular, cultivated, at saka grapevine sources. Pupunta na tayo sa pangalawang eye, the second eye. Yung tinatawag na interview, at saka interrogation. Sir, magkatulad ba yan? Sa spelling pa lang, magkaiba na. Okay. Magkaiba yung interview at interrogation. Okay. Sir, paano kung yung witness ay willing naman, cooperative naman? Anong gagawin mo sa kanya? Kailangan mo ba siyang interrogate? O interview lang natin? Okay. Interview lang. Sir, paano kung yung suspect ayaw magsalita or yung witness reluctant siya, uncooperative, anong gagawin namin? Interview lang namin siya o interrogate namin siya? Interrogate natin siya. So ano ngayon ang kaibahan ng interrogation at saka interview? Okay, let us now differentiate interview from interrogation. Okay. Simple but skillful questioning of a person who is cooperating with the investigator. Anong keyword dito? The word cooperating. Pag nakikipag-cooperate naman yan, yung witness na yan, don't conduct interrogation, don't interrogate. Anong dapat mong gawin? You must conduct interview. Okay. Isa, paano kung yung witness na yan is a hostile witness? Tawag yan, hostile witness. Isang, pag sinabing hostile, uncooperative, reluctant na magbigay ng information. Hostile siya. Anong gagawin namin? Okay. E di mag-conduct ka ng interrogation. Ano interrogation na yan? It is the vigorous questioning of a person who is reluctant or uncooperative to the investigator. Okay. So, ang keyword dito is a vigorous questioning of a person who is reluctant or uncooperative to the CI. So, pagka uncooperative siya, reluctant siya magbigay ng information, ang gawin mo sa kanya, interrogate mo siya. So, paano para ng kaibahan yan? Sa interview, mag-ask ka lang ng mga normal questions. Okay? Pero pag sa interrogation, it must be forceful. It must be vigorous. May halong, kung hindi naman pagbabanta, may halong pananakot. Pag hindi ka nagsalita, alam mo na ang mangyayari sa'yo. Yan. That's interrogation. Magsalita ka na kasi. Pinapahirapan mo kami. Sige ka. Mamaya ka. Yan. Pero pag interview, ah, ganun ba? So, pakikwento mo nga yung nangyari. Ano bang nangyari? Paano ba nangyari? Kailan nangyari? Okay. Pero pagka ini-interrogate mo siya, alam na namin na ginawa mo yan, ba't ayaw mo pang umamin? Yan. Ba't ayaw mo pang magsalita? Hindi ka ba natatakot sa amin? Gusto mo tokhang ka namin? That's interrogation. So, may pagkakaiba as to the principle and as to the manner of conducting interview from that of interrogation. But both of these, interview and interrogation, isa lang ang objective. To acquire information. Anong information ay acquire mo nito? Either admission or confession. Gusto mong makakuha ng admission or gusto mong makakuha ng confession. Anong pagkakaiba niyan, sir? Yung admission sa confession, malaki pagkakaiba niyan. Pag sinabi natin confession, inamin na niya na siyang may kasalanan. Okay. Directly acknowledging his guilt. Okay. Nakapag-secure ka na ngayon ng confession. Susog ka na. Hindi ka na nahirapan. But if ang ginawa lang ng tao na ini-interview mo or in-interrogate mo is nagbigay siya ng admission only. Okay. Ang ginawa niya is nag-acknowledge lang siya ng mga facts and circumstances but not directly acknowledging his guilt. Ibig sabihin, halimbawa confession, sasabihin niya, opo, ako ang pumatay. That's confession. Ako ang bumaril. That's confession. Pag sinabi naman na niya na, oo sir, andun ako. Pero hindi akong gumawa. That's admission. Positive siya sa lugar. Okay? Opo, sa akin yung baril. Pero hindi sinabi na siya ang bumaril. Okay. That is admission. So, ganun din, pag nag-interview tayo, gusto natin makakuha ng information. Pag nag-interrogate, gusto natin makakuha ng information. Information na kung sakali magkakaroon ng admission or magkakaroon ng confession. Okay, yan yung pagkakaiba. Sa terminology, tinuturuan tayo yung proper conduct of interview. Maraming pamamaraan yan. Kapag nag-interview ka daw, you must establish yung tinatawag na rapport. Okay? Yung letter R, rapport. Ano yung rapport na yan? Lumalabas sa exam, rapport. Ang ibig sabihin ng rapport, this is the connection between the interviewer and the interviewee. Nag-establish ka ng rapport. Bakit? Sa isang interviewer at interviewee, lalong-lalo na kung ang involved ay pag-iimbestiga ng crime, nagkakaroon ng tinatawag na gap. Gap between the interviewer at saka interviewee. Itong gap na to ay mas may kukonekta mo kung mayroon kang rapport. So yun ang dapat nating establish. At sa pag-interrogate, mamaya malalaman natin yung mga technique, police technique sa pag-interrogate ng mga witnesses and suspect. Okay. And the last I. Reason natin to. Yung panghuling I as a tool of criminal investigation ay yung tinatawag na instrumentation. Ito na yung pangatlong I. Instrumentation. Okay. In short, sa criminology, dito na papasok yung mga kalaman natin sa criminalistics. Okay. Ano ba yung mga criminalistics na yan? O yung binabanggit natin kanina? Dapat may alam ka sa polygraphy, dactyloscopy, ballistic, question document, and many others. Sa forensic medicine, forensic chemistry, yan yung mga kaalaman na nasa kriminolohiya na hindi mo napapag-aralan sa ibang kurso. Kaya be proud kung tayo ay graduate ng criminology. Ipagmalaki natin kung tayo ay criminologist. Dahil dito pa lang, talo na natin yung iba. Marunong tayo ng instrumentation. Okay, paano ba ginagamit ng CI itong instrumentation na to? In the advancement of science and technology, kung hindi ka makakuha ng sapat na impormasyon from other sources, hindi ka makapag-extract ng admission or confession, kailangan through the use of criminalistics o yung tinatawag na police science. Ano mga police science na ito yung binanggit ko kanina? Okay, either instrumentation, criminalistic, or police science, parehas yan. Gagamitin mo yun to process evidence. Okay. Yung mga ebidensya na magpapatunay na yung taong iniimbestigan ay may kasalanan. Okay. Para mapatunayan na mayroon siyang kasalanan, guilt, gumamit ka ng instrumentation. So that's the three eyes of criminal investigation. Okay, tandaan nyo yan, lalabas sa exam yan. Three eyes of criminal investigation. The three eyes of criminal investigation. Okay? Three eyes. Okay, number one, information. Number two, interview. Interrogation. Number three, instrumentation. That's the three eyes. Ito yung tinatawag na tools of CI, of criminal investigator. That's the tools. Okay? So, yan po. Nasa preliminary pa lang tayo, introduction pa lang yun ng criminal investigation. Sa criminology, ang criminal fundamentals of criminal investigation is a 6 months subject. Okay? Pero dito kukunin lang natin ng oras. Okay. Now, using that tools, yung 3 I's na yan, yung 3 I's of criminal investigation, gagawin na natin yung unang objective ng CI, yun yung identification. Balikan natin yung objective kanina. Okay. Yung number one objective is yung identification of criminals. Gagamitin na natin yung 3 I's na yan to identify criminals. Okay? Okay, tandaan natin na yung mga criminals na yan, mayroon yung tinatawag na known criminals at saka unknown criminals. Pag known criminals, may record na yan. Pag unknown criminals, walang record yan. Yan yung mahirap hanapin. Pero pag known criminal na yan, madaling hanapin yan. May record na siya. Okay? Pero pag unknown yan, first-timer, mahirap-hirap yan. Mahirap siyang i-identify. Okay? So, marami mga klase ng criminals. Okay. Known, unknown criminals. Pag may record, is a known criminal. Pag walang record, unknown criminal. So, pag lumabas sa board exam yan, madali lang yan. It's a matter of logic. Okay. Pag sinabing may record na, on the police files, is a known criminal. Pag wala pang record, unknown criminal. Okay. So, identification of criminal. Pwede mo i-identify ang criminal sa pamamagitan ng tinatawag na confession or admission. Pag may nag-confess, sabi niya, "Sir, si ganito ang nang bumaril niyan." Okay. Yung confession na yon, "Sir, ang kasama kong pumatay ay si ganito." That's confession. Okay? So, na-identify na natin yung mga unknown. Okay? Nagkaroon na tayo ng identification. Pero, sa police, paano ba na-identify yung mga criminal? Okay? Halimbawa, may nangyaring krimen. Crime is being committed. Yung mga suspect or suspects ay at large. Ibig sabihin ng at large, hindi nahuli. Nakatakas sila. They are at large. Okay. So, ang problema ng pulis ngayon, ang tanong niya, sasagutin niya yung unang tanong, yung who. Who? Sino ang gumawa sa krimen na yan? Who? Who commit or who committed that crime? Okay. Who committed that crime? At para masagot yan, kailangan niya ng tools. Okay. Anong kailangan natin para masagot yan? Para malaman natin yung suspect, yung at-large na suspect, para masagot yung who question. Para masolve natin yung crime. Okay, mayroon yung tinatawag na verbal description. Verbal description. Anong verbal description? Mayroong witness or eyewitness. Halimbawa, mayroon tayong eyewitness. Kaisa-isang eyewitness. Through verbal description, sabi niya, "Sir, nakita ko yung bumaril." Then, i-describe niya yung itsura niya. Okay? I-describe niya. I-describe niya yung facial features. Okay? Facial features. I-describe niya yung physical features. Sir, mataba yan. Sir, malaki ang tiyan yan. Okay? Sir, kalbo yan. Sir, mahabang buhok yan. Sir, maiting yan. Sir, chinito yan. Okay? So, that is true verbal description. Okay? Verbal description. Sir, matangos ang ilong yan. Sir, pango ang ilong yan. Okay? So, verbal description. I-describe niya. Okay? Then, sa parang paraan pa, okay, aside from verbal description, pwede rin ma-identify ang isang suspect or criminal by the use of tinatawag na Rogues Gallery. Ano tong Rogues Gallery? Ito yung mga files, photographic files ng pulisya. Okay. May sample ako ng Rogues Gallery dito sa amin. Okay. Yung mga naipon na files ng mga nahuling suspect, andyan lahat yan. Papakita mo yan. Siya ba? Siya ba? Sino dito? Baka may kamukha siya dito. Papakita mo. Gagamit tayo ng Rogues Gallery. Ano yung Rogues Gallery na yan? Photographs of known criminals. Dahil may records sila. Papakita mo yan isa-isa. Ma-identify mo nga. Siya ba? Siya ba yung nakita mo? Yan. So marami yan. Yan yung paggamit ng Rogues Gallery. Photograph of known criminals. Either arrested or with records of that police station. Okay. Then, yung pangatlo, yung pagpapakita ng tinatawag na general photographs. General photographs. Ano yung general photographs? Magpapakita ka ng iba't ibang facial features ng tao. Ano siya? Mataba ba siya? Ganito ba siya? Yung buhok niya ganito? Yung buhok niya armikat? Yung buhok niya mahaba? Maiksi? Stout ba siya? Thin ba siya? Matangkad ba siya? So, papakitaan mo siya hanggang mabuo yung description ng suspect or criminal. So, pwede natin ma-identify ulit ang isang criminal by verbal description, by Rogues Gallery o photographic files, at by general photographs. Ito yung mahirap sa online kasi hindi mo, parang wala kang nakikita as if nagsasalita ka sa harapan ng camera. Okay. So, at saka yung focus mo sa sinasabi mo. Okay. Then, pang-apat na pamamaraan para ma-identify ang criminal ay yung tinatawag na artist. Ayun, sumulat. Artist assistance. Okay. Habang di-describe ng eyewitnesses or eyewitness yung mga nakita nila o nakita niya, may isang tao na nag-drawing, dinodrawing niya. Itong artist assistance na to, pag nagawa niya yung drawing niya, yun yung tinatawag na composite illustration. Okay. It is not an exact face of that criminal, but it will resemble his appearance. Ibig sabihin, maaaring hindi eksakto, pero yung hawig, based on the description ng eyewitness, yun yun. Ito yung pinagbabasehan, yung composite illustration, para hanapin yung criminal. Para sabihin, pag ipapan sa TV, ito yung mukha ng suspect, pag may nakakita, paki-report. So, composite illustration ang tawag doon. At ang gumagawa niyan yung artist. Okay. By artist assistance.
Okay.
Paano pa ma-identify ang suspect? Ang ginagawa ng kapulisan ay nagkakandak sila ng tinatawag na police lineup. Okay? Yung eyewitness, ang gagawin ng police, iharap siya. Ilaline up yung suspect sa mga innocent person. Pwede niyang isali yung police doon, yan. Yung eyewitness, sasabihin niya, ituro mo dyan kung sino yung nakita mo. Okay. At pag itinuro, it is a positive identification. Okay. Paano daw ginagawa? 10 persons, almost magkakamukha, ilaline up nila, 10. Ihalo mo doon yung suspect at yung eyewitness tuturo niya. Asan dyan? Dapat ituro niya. Okay? So, haluan mo yung mga innocent individuals. At pag naituro yung suspect, it is considered a positive identification. So, yan yung mga pamamaraan how to identify criminals. Then, we can also identify criminals by utilizing yung tinatawag na associative evidence. Okay. Sa lahat ng krimen, sabi nga nila, mayroon at mayroon kang makukuhang ebidensya. Even though how minute it is, gaano kalit ito, mayroon at mayroon na iwan niyang perpetrator na yan or suspect na yan doon sa crime scene. Ang kailangan lang ng pulis ay hanapin ito. At pag nahanap mo ito, gamitin mo ito to link that piece of evidence or pieces of evidence to the suspect. Ang tawag doon ay paggamit ng associative evidence. Okay. Using of associative evidence to identify criminal. Okay. To identify criminal. Using associative evidence. Ano itong associative evidence? Ito yung either yung fingerprint or personal property ng suspect na naiwan doon sa crime scene. May blood stain or may nahulog na buhok. Yun yung magliling sa kanya. Ano ibig sabihin? Pag may nakuha kang fingerprint dun sa crime scene, at it's a latent print, ipoproseso, okay, ililift, then pag napatunayan na yung fingerprint ng suspect ay parehas dun sa fingerprint, latent print na nalift from the scene of the crime, at nagmatch, ano ibig sabihin nun? Yung suspect na yun ay positive dun sa area. Okay, so na-associate na siya. Nagkaroon siya ng link yung suspect dun sa scene of the crime and to the crime committed. Okay. Aside from associative evidence, pwede rin nating ma-identify isang criminal via the use of modus operandi or yung tinatawag na MO. Itong modus operandi, it is a modus operandi file na sa police station. Dahil sa dami na nang nagawang krimen, nagkaroon na sila ng file, yung modus operandi file. At pag naulit muli yung pamamaraan paano ginawa yung krimen, masasabi ng police kung sino yung gumawa niyan. Anong organization, sinong individual, sinong person using the modus operandi file. Ano yung MO? Yun yung mode of operation. Paano nila ginagawa yung krimen? So either by modus operandi, by associative evidence, by the use of rogues gallery, by the use of police lineup, by the use of verbal description, or yung any other photographic files, we can identify criminals. That's identification of criminals. So, tapos na natin yung first objective. Identification of criminal using those discuss. Okay. Now, if we already identified the suspect, identify na natin, nasagot na yung question na who. Okay, who? Okay na. Yung question na who is nasagot na. Okay na. Ano ngayon ang next na dapat gawin ng criminal investigator? This is now the time para pumunta ka sa ikalawang objective. Ito yung to locate and to trace yung suspect. I-locate mo na siya. I-trace mo na siya. Okay. So, identified na siya. Identified na yan. Okay na yan. May identification na siya. Ano ibig sabihin ng identification? May pangalan na siya. Kilala na siya. Ano na lang susunod na gagawin is to locate at saka to trace. Nasaan yan? Okay. Nasaan yan? At paano natin gagawin yon? Yun nga, balikan natin yung sinasabi natin. First, by the use of informants. Okay. Informants. Itong informants na to, either confidential, anonymous, or any kind of informants. Okay. So, dito na tayo sa laptop natin kasi medyo marami na to. Iisa-isahin natin, i-describe yung how to trace and locate criminals. Okay, sabi dito, tracing and locating the criminal through the use of informants. Okay, yung mga informants na yan, tao yan. Person who gives information to the investigator. Okay. Types of informants. Okay, take note of this. We have a confidential informant. Confidential informant, they provide information about past or future crime but does not want to be identified as the source of information. Ano yung ibig sabihin yan? Ayaw nilang makilala. So, they must remain confidential. Ayaw nang makilala yung pagkatao nila. Okay, that's the first type of informant. The second type of informant is anonymous. Those who gives information through anonymous call or letters. Tatawag yan sa opisina ng pulis. Sir, kilala ko sinong pumatay. Sir, alam ko kung nasan siya. Okay. That's an anonymous informant. Hindi siya nagpapakilala. Itong confidential, kilala to ng pulis, pero sabi niya, sir, I want to remain anonymous. Huwag mo nang ilabas ang pagkakakilanlan ko. How about yung informant na tinatawag na rival elimination? It informs to eliminate his rivals or competition. Ano ibig sabihin niyan? May kalaban siya or may kakompetensya siya sa mga criminal activities nila. Halimbawa, they are involved in drugs. Ang gagawin niya to eliminate his rival, isusumbong niya yung kalaban niya. That rival elimination. It will favor the police kung ganyan. Okay? Mayroon din yung tinatawag na false informant. So, dapat ang police hindi naniniwala. But although it is false, dapat i-treat pa rin niya ito as totoo. Dapat magsagawa siya ng tinatawag na verification and validation. Who is that false informant? This false informant, they provide information which is usually of no consequence or simply concocted out of thin air. Gawa-gawa yung sinasabi nila. That's false. Okay. Eh, sino naman yung tinatawag na frightened informant? They are being compelled by fear or self-interest. Takot siya. Takot siyang bawian siya. So, dapat, kaya ang ginagawa niya, magsusumbong na lang ako. Sir, natatakot ako. Kasi, alam niya na ako lang ang nakakita sa kanya. Yan, susumbong niya ngayon. Baka balikan niya ako. Baka bawian niya ako. Okay, sino naman tong self-aggrandizing informant? Okay, itong mga dinidiscuss natin to, pwedeng lumabas sa board to. Actually, lumalabas ito.
yung self-aggrandizing informant, they are being delighted in surprising the police with bits of information purporting to have come from criminal groups. Okay? So, gusto nang surprise yung police. Sir, may alam ako. Alam po niyo man na ganito, ganito. Okay? So, self-aggrandizing yan. Tawag yan. Eh, sino yung mga mercenary? Mercenary informants. Itong mercenary informants, ito yung tinatawag na paid informants. Mga binabayaran, bayaran. Okay, mercenary. Mayroon din tayong tinatawag na double crosser. Dapat nag-iingat ang pulis dyan. They use information as an excuse to talk to the police in order to get information. Sir, mayroon kong alam. Yun pala, gusto lang nilang makakuha ng impormasyon dun sa pulis. So dapat maging matalino ang pulis. Huwag silang magpapagamit. Huwag silang bigay ng information. Kasi baka ma-double cross sila. Isa double crosser. Okay. Ito ang mahirap na informant. Sabi nila, a woman informant. Female informants who are usually associates of the criminal. Yan yung mga, yan, prostitute, nagtatrabaho sa club, na laging nakakahalubilo ng criminals, o mga gumagawa hindi maganda. So, pwede yan. Pero mag-ingat tayo sa mga woman informant. Pwede rin tayong ipasubo niyan. Okay? Huwag tayo magtitiwala. Dapat maingat. We must treat them with caution. Yung double crosser at saka tong woman informant. Yung woman kasi na yan, pabago-bago ang isip at madaling impluensyahan. Okay. Who is that legitimate informant? Pag sinabing legitimate, eh lahat na sabi niyan, totoo yan. Maniwala tayo yan. They are owners of licensed establishment who do not want their place of business to be hiding places of criminals. Dahil sa interest nila na ayaw nilang maging pugad ng criminality yung kanilang establishment, magsasabi sila ng impormasyon sa pulis. Sir, dito sila nagtatago. Sir, dito nila ginagawa yung kanilang deals sa drugs. Okay. They are legitimate informants. Okay. Okay, question. Question. This is an informant who fears that his or her life is in imminent danger. Okay. Let us have this sample question. Sino daw siya? Ang keyword natin dito, nandun yung word na fear of his or her life. Is he a mercenary? Is he a double crosser? Is he a false informant? Or is he a frightened informant? The correct answer is here is frightened informant. Nandun yung keyword, yung fear. Bakit hindi mercenary? Ang sabi natin, mercenary is a paid informant. Okay. Double crosser, they are informant who gives information just to acquire information from police. How about false informant? Their information are concocted. Ibig sabihin, gawa-gawa, hindi totoo. Okay. So that is a sample question sa board. Okay. Para makapagpahinga ako, let's have a review dun sa una, tapos tutuloy natin mamaya. I-review natin kung may naiwan sa inyo. Okay, review. This is a sample question. An art which aims to achieve the objectives of criminal investigation is the job of the blank. Is the job of the criminal evidence, letter A. The job of criminal investigation, the job of criminal investigator, or the job of a criminal procedure. Using your logic, kahit hindi ka na nag-review, ang hinahanap dito ay tao. Okay, tao. An art which aims to achieve the objectives of criminal investigation. Nilito lang tayo. Pero ang inahanap dito ay tao. Is the job of the hindi criminal investigation. Ang tamang sagot dito ay ano? Criminal investigator. Kasi ang hinanap natin ay tao. Tao. Pero pag ang tanong, it is an art which aim to achieve the objectives of identifying, identification of a criminal, location of criminal, at saka providing of his guilt, ang sagot dyan ay criminal investigation. Ang hinanap dito ay tao. Is the job of the criminal investigation. Okay, next question. Ito na. An art which aims to achieve the objectives of criminal investigation is the job of the naulit lang. Criminal investigator. Naulit lang. Okay. Okay, next question. These are the objectives of criminal investigation, yung topic natin kanina. Which one deals with tracing the offender? Tracing, ha? Tracing. Ang keyword natin dito ay tracing. Is it the production of evidence of the offender's guilt? Letter A. Letter B. Is it location of the offender? Or letter C. Identification of the criminal? Or letter D. All of them. The correct answer here is location of the offender. Facing from the keyword tracing. Natitrace natin. So, it means we are locating the offender. Location of the offender. Letter B. Okay. Ano yung three tools of criminal investigation? Yung kanina. Yung three eyes of criminal investigation. We have the first eye is information. The second eye is interrogation and interview. And the third eye is instrumentation. Okay, that's it. Okay, question. This is a board question. Criminalistics is the use of forensic sciences to solve crimes. Tama naman. In criminal investigation, it is otherwise known as what? Is it criminology? Is it instrumentation? It is forensic? Is it improvisation? Okay. So, let us see. Criminology graduate tayo. Unang-una pa lang. Alam na natin dapat, memorize natin dapat ang definition ng criminology. Criminology is a scientific study of crimes and criminals. So, hindi naman yun. Ang hinahanap dito is ito. In criminal investigation, it is otherwise known as what? Yung criminalistic. It is otherwise known as yung third eye of criminal investigation. Instrumentation. Okay? Instrumentation. Okay. Another question. These are criminals whose records and pictures are readily available in the police records. Anong klaseng criminal dito? What type of criminals? Are they famous criminals? Letter A. Letter B. Are they unknown criminals? Are they recidivist criminals? Or are they known criminals? Anong sagot nyo? Is it A, B, or C, or D? Ang tamang sagot dito ay known criminals. Why? They have available pictures or records in the police files or police records. So therefore, they are known. Okay, they are known. Okay. Ito yung kaibahan ng confessions, admission as a matter of review. Sabi natin, confession is the direct acknowledgement by the accused in a criminal case of his or her guilt. Ano ibig sabihin ng confession? Pag sinabi ng suspect or accused, "Sir, ako ang pumatay. Sir, ako ang nagnakaw." Okay, ang tawag dyan is confession. But if the statement of facts provided by the accused in a criminal case do not directly acknowledge his or her guilt in the commission of crime, ang tawag doon ay admission only. It is just an admission. Sabi niya, "Sir, totoo po, andun ako nung araw na yon at oras na yon." Okay. "Totoo po, ako po yan nakita sa CCTV na nandyan." That's an admission. Pero hindi niya sinasabing siya ang may gawa nung krimen. He is not acknowledging his or her guilt. So that's the difference between confession and admission. Malaking pagkakaiba. Okay. Now, question. Ito. Please answer this. When the suspect admits his guilt in the commission of a crime and accepts his liability for it, sinabi niya, inadmit na niya, "Ako po ang pumatay. Ako po ang nagnakaw." Anong tawag yan? Letter A, is it admission? B, is it commission? C, is it omission? Or letter D, is it confession? Ano siya? Confession? Omission? Commission or admission? Try to answer. The keyword here is, ano? The suspect admits his guilt. That's the keyword. Admits his guilt. So what's the answer? Is it admission? Is it commission? Is it omission? Or is it confession? The right answer is confession. Confession. Bakit? He acknowledges his guilt. Inamin na niya. Nagko-confess na siya. Okay, that's confession. Okay, that's confession. Okay, that's confession. Okay, here another question. It is the modern version of an old technique of manually sketching the facial features of a suspect is now called what? It is the modern version na. Dati kasi, dinodrawing-drawing. Anong tawag yan? Anong tawag yan? Is it digital imaging? Is it cartography? Is it Adobe Photoshop? Or is it composite illustration? Any answer? Digital imaging, cartography, Adobe Photoshop, or composite illustration? The modern version of old techniques of manually sketching the facial features of a suspect. Anong tawag daw ngayon? Anong tawag yan? Anong tawag yan? The modern version. Letter D. Okay. Amboy Abalyang. Sir Amboy Abalaing. Okay. Nalaing ka. Abalaing. Si Sir Amboy Abalaing. Letter D. Composite illustration. How about this question? Ito, pag-isipan nyo. How about this question? Identification of an eyewitness by giving description of the suspect like the shape of his face, nose, eyes, ears, verbally. So may keyword na dyan. Andun yung keyword, oh. The word verbally and the word giving description. So ano rito? Is it letter D, Rogues Gallery? Is it by the use of general photograph? Is it by the use of police lineup? Or letter A, is it by verbal description? So hanapin nyo yung keyword. They give description. By how means? Paano? Verbally. Pag sinabing verbally, orally, yan, verbally. Sinabi. So, hanapin nyo rito. The correct answer is, very good. Norberto, Sir Norberto Reyes, Sir Norman. Okay. Sir Kim Harold Egaña, letter A, verbal description. So sa board exam, it is just a use of logic, the process of proper elimination. The use of logic, okay? The use of rational thinking, andyan na yan. Yung question pa lang, ibinibigay na niya yung answer. So the right answer here is verbal description. Very good. Verbal description. Okay, ito. Every police station maintains a photographic file of known criminals. Totoo yan. For easier identification and cross-reference. This is a method of identification of the criminal by a way of what? Okay, mayroon siyang photographic file, okay, dito, ng mga known criminal. Okay, itong method daw na to is a method of identification of criminal by way of, okay, is it by verbal description? Is it by police lineup? Or is it by general photograph? Or is it by the means of Ruggs gallery? Ruggs gallery ba yan? Police lineup ba yan? Or general photograph yan? Or yan ba ay verbal description method? Ano siya? Okay, very good. Very good, Sir Gondi Pagaran, Sir Norberto Reyes, Andrew, letter C, J.R. Ilumin, Clinton Cartero, Jovelin Gallo. Okay, very good. Very good kayo lahat. Nakukuha na ninyo by means of Ruggs Gallery. Okay, by Ruggs Gallery. Okay, eto, this question. Titignan natin. Okay, are you ready? The next question is this. This refers to the pertinent characteristic or characteristics that a criminal or a group of criminals use in the performance of their criminal act. In CI, we call this what? Can we call it as a mode of operation? Yan. Can we call it modus operandi? Can we call it MO? Or is it all of them? The three of them. Ano siya? This refers to the pertinent characteristics that a criminal or group of criminals use in the performance of their criminal act. Ito yung ginagamit nila. Ito yung pamamaraan nila. Ano siya? Mode of operation? Modus operandi, MO, or all of them? Ano siya? Huwag kayong malito. Are they all of them? MO, modus operandi, or mode of operation? Sa criminal investigation, anong tawag natin yan? Pwede bang mode of operation? Pwede bang MO? Pwede bang modus operandi? Ano? Is it A, B, C, or D? All of them. Medyo nagkakaiba-iba yung sagot. Are they all of them? Sa criminal investigation, pwede ba nating tawagin niya ng MO, modus operandi, or mode of operation? Ano? Very good. Yan ay all of them. MO yan. O, ano yung MO nila? Anong modus operandi nila? Ano yung mode of operation nila? Okay, that's it. Very good. Letter D, all of them. Okay. I-discuss natin tong types of informants. I-review lang natin. Types of informants: confidential, anonymous, rival elimination, false, frightened, self-aggrandizing, mercenary, lumalabas sa board yan, double crosser, woman, or legitimate informant. Okay. Ito, lumalabas din sa board. Yung motives of informant. Bakit sila nagbibigay ng information? Ano yung motibo nila? Okay. Number one motive. Yung tinatawag na vanity. They want to gain favorable attention from the police. Okay. Gusto nilang magpalakas sa police. Ah, okay to ah. Sige, magbibigay ako ng informasyon sa police para maging kilala ako, makilala ako nila. Okay. Para malakas ako. Para pag may problema ako, pwede kong maarbor. That's vanity. Okay. Magpapalakas sa police. Para pag may kaibigan akong police, feeling ko, malakas ako. Okay. Feeling ko, hindi ako pwedeng banggain nino. That's vanity. Okay. How about being sa civic-mindedness? They provide information because they are civic-spirited persons. Ano ang gusto nila? They want that justice is served. So, ito yung concerned citizen. Yan mga yan, civic-mindedness. Okay. But if they give information out of fear, bakit? Natatakot sila. Under the belief that their lives is in danger. Either yung takot nila na yon ay totoo or imaginary. Mayroon silang takot. Okay. They fear something. Okay. How about yung repentance? Kung gusto ko nang magbagong buhay, yan. Gusto ko nang ituwid ang aking mga pagkakamali. Sila yung mga taong nagre-repent na. Okay. Gusto nilang magbago. So they are repenting. Okay, kaya nagbibigay sila ng information. How about naman yung nagbibigay ng information na they are avoiding punishment. They avoid punishment. Okay. So, pag sinabi ng police, ano? Pag hindi ka nagbigay ng impormasyon, gusto mo hulihin kita? May alam akong ginawa mo. O para hindi sila mahuli or maka-escape sila sa punishment or hindi sila, halimbawa, petty crimes lang yan, palit ulo, sabi ng police. Ano, magbibigay ka ng impormasyon o ikaw ang kakasuhan namin? Huhulihin kita. Just to avoid punishment, just to avoid apprehension, they will provide information. Yan yung tinatawag na avoiding punishment as a motive of an informant. Ano man yung tinatawag na gratitude or gain? Halimbawa, ang police. Yung police, minsan natulungan niya yung isang tao. At yung taong natulungan na yon, they want to give back to the police. Gusto nilang makabawi for the good deeds na ginawa ng police. Okay. In exchange, nung ginawa ang kabutihan ng police sa kanila, they will provide information. That is a gratitude or gain. Out of gratitude, marunong silang tumanaw ng utang na loob. They will provide information. How about this? Pag may competition, it's a rival group, at gusto nila eliminate yung kalaban nila in criminal world or in their criminal business, ano gagawin nila? Magpipid sila ng information. Either anonymously. Okay. Sasabi, sir, sila to. Sir, silang gumawa. Just to eliminate their business rivals. Ito ang mahirap. Ito ang dapat paniwalaan. Yung tinatawag na out of revenge, they will provide information. They will give information to settle a grudge or to get back to person who had done wrong with them. Ano ibig sabihin niyan? It is revenge. Babawi ako. Ah, may alam akong ginawa mo. Susumbong kita sa pulis para mahuli ka. Para makabawi ako. That's revenge. Gusto nilang maghiganti. Okay, revenge. Out of jealousy naman. Halimbawa, naiinggit. Ang dami niyang naibebentang droga. Wala na kaming nabebentahan. Marami siyang parokyano. Out of jealousy. Just to eliminate. Okay. Isusumbong kita. Or, nagsiselos siya. Bakit niya ako hindi sinagot? Mas sinagot niya yung pangit na yan. Nagsiselos siya. Ngayon, dahil nagsiselos ako, isusumbong kita. Ipapahuli kita. Pangit ka na nga. Okay. May ginagawa ka pang masama. Oh, jealousy. Susumbong kita. How about tong remuneration? Lumalabas sa board exam ito. Pag sinabing they provide information for pecuniary reason. Okay, ano ibig sabihin niyan? Nagpapabayad mga yan. Okay. Sila yung mga tinatawag na mercenary informant. They provide information because they are being paid. Yan. So, out of remuneration. Yan ang motive nila. Eh, bayaran mo ako bago kita bigyan ng information. So, they are the so-called informers. Okay. Nagpapabayad sila. Ang tawag sa kanila, paid informants. Okay, mga, ito na. Okay, let's try to answer this. It includes criminals or those who are involved in criminal activities who wants to go back to the path of righteousness. Okay. Or simply, those who have had a change of heart. Gusto nilang magbago. Okay, gusto nilang magbago. Anong tawag sa mga criminal na to? Anong motive ng criminal na to? Are they because of vanity? Is it because of avoidance of punishment? Is it because of repentance? Or is it because of remuneration? Okay. Ano yan? A. Remuneration. B. Repentance. C. Avoidance of punishment. Or D. Vanity. Ano siya? Okay. Very good. Letter B. Repentance. Pag sinabing nagre-repent ka, pag sinabing nagre-repent ka, ano ibig sabihin yan? Nagsisisi ka na. You want to go back to the path of righteousness. Naligaw yung landas mo. Gusto mo nang ituwid. Okay. Nagkaroon ka ng change of heart. Ayoko na. Ayoko nang magbenta ng droga. Okay. Ayoko nang magnakaw. Ayoko na. Ayoko na. So nagre-repent ka. Very good. Letter B. Very good. Very good. Okay, very good. Sir Ren Silva, very good. Sir Andrew, very good. Sir Ramil Gesta, sabi niya, B as in baboy na, very good. Baboy, repentance, sabi ni Sir Juana May Magat, very good. Ang gagaling ninyo. Ang gagaling na mga perlo, mga amisay natin. Ang gagaling. So nakikita ko ngayon, pagdating ng board examination, kahit matagal pa, kahit na-postpone ngayon, ipapasa nyo ang board exam pagdating sa fundamentals of criminal investigation. Okay? So, magbabasa lang tayo ng message. Okay? So kukunin ko tong pagkakataon na to. I want to thank Attorney J. Ferraro. Attorney, thank you so much. Itong ginagawa mo to reach out those students sa pamamagitan ng social media, this is something. Ang laki ng tulong nito. Okay, ang talaki ng tulong ng ginagawa natin. Nabibigyan natin ng inspirasyon yung ating mga estudyante, yung mga nagre-review, yung mga nangangarap para matupad ang kanilang mga pangarap. Okay. And if given the chance, next time, gusto ko ulit, even though this is free, Attorney Ferraro, thank you so much. So, sana pasalamatan natin si Attorney Ferraro sa naisip niya na to. This is something for us. Kami na lecturer, natututo sa inyo habang nag-i-explain kami. And we hope na kayo na mga nanonood via FV Live may natututuhan sa aming mga lecturers ninyo. Okay. Ito na. Pupunta na tayo sa how to trace and locate criminals. Okay. How to trace and locate criminals. Maraming pamamaraan. Ito lumalabas sa board yan. Tandaan natin. Yung word na surveillance, hindi man lalabas dito sa criminal investigation, lalabas yan sa iba pang subject, sa police investigation, lalabas yan. Yung word na surveillance. Okay. This is one way to trace and locate criminals by surveillance method. What is surveillance? Okay, pag nag-conduct tayo ng surveillance, the meaning of surveillance, ito, take note, the disguise or secret observation of places, persons, and vehicles for the purpose of obtaining, yun na, information concerning the identities or activities of the subjects of criminals. So, pag sinabing secret or disguise, ibig sabihin yan, covert, yan. Baka palitan lang yung word kasi. Covert observation of places, persons, and vehicles for the purpose of obtaining information concerning the identities or activities of subject or criminals. That's surveillance. Yan tinawag na surveillance operation. So, tatlo ang involved dito. Places, mga lugar, persons, tao, or vehicles. Okay. Anong tawag dun sa nagkakandak ng surveillance operation? Ang tawag sa kanya, take note, is he's being called surveillant. Surveillant. Okay. The person who conduct or maintains the surveillance operation. Ano yung subject? Sir, yung subject ba na yan? Yan yung pinapag-aralan natin? No. Ibang subject ito. Pag sinabing subject, they are the person or place being surveyed. Sina yung surveillance natin? Yung places, persons, or vehicles, ang tawag sa kanila is subject. Okay. Pag sinusundan mo yung tao, sinusundan mo. Yung sasakyan, sinusundan mo. Okay. Yung lugar, sinusurveillance mo. Ang tawag sa kanya, they are the subject of your surveillance operation. So, maliwanag yun. Okay. Question. Ayan. Try to answer this question. Katatapos lang. The person who is in charge of the surveillance operation. Sino daw tong tao na to? In charge. Baka malito kayo. Doon sa word na in charge of the surveillance operation. Is he the team leader? Is he the ground commander? Is he being called surveillant? Or letter D, siya ba yung tinatawag na undercover agent? Okay, try to answer this. Ano siya? Team leader ba siya? Ground commander ba siya? Surveillant ba ang tawag sa kanya? O undercover agent? Anong tamang sagot? Anong tao ang sagot? Is it letter A, B, C, or D? Ano mas maraming sagot? Mas maraming letter C. Tama, very good. He is being called a surveillant. Bakit? Sinasabi niya, no? A surveillant is a person who maintains the surveillance operation. So, ang tamang sagot dito ay surveillant. Surveillant. Okay. Eh, sir, may team leader siya eh. Wala tayong pakialam sa team leader niya. Basta, ang tawag sa kanya are surveillant. Okay. Surveillant. Very good. Letter C. Surveillant. Surveillant. Very good. Letter C. Ang gagaling. Ang gagaling ninyo. Ang gagaling. Okay. Ito, kinds of surveillance. Sabi natin kanina, mayroon tinatawag na surveillance of places. Mayroon din tinatawag na tailing or shadowing. Anong kaibahan ng tailing or shadowing? Okay, mamaya. Mayroon ding undercover investigation or yung tinatawag na roping. Okay. Ito yung kinds of surveillance. Are you surveying for places? Are you tailing or shadowing somebody? Or are you conducting undercover operation or investigation? Or yung tinatawag na roping? Tingnan natin. Pag sinabing surveillance of places, yan yung ino-observe natin yung places. Okay, that's self-explanatory. Ano yung tinatawag na casing? Pag may isosurvey ka na lugar, okay, pag iso, sasubject mo sa surveillance, pag i-initial, survey mo muna siya. Okay, pupuntahan mo muna siya. Check mo muna. At pagkakaroon ka ng careful survey of the surrounding, ano ba ng mga nandito? Ano ba tong environment to? Ano pang surrounding nito? At dito namin gagawin yung surveillance namin. Ang tawag doon, kinikasing na yan. Kinikasing na yan. Nagkakandak ka na ng initial operation bago mo gawin yung actual surveillance operation. Ang tawag doon, casing. Kinikasing mo muna. Okay. That's an initial conduct of surveillance operation. Okay. How about yung tinatawag na tailing or shadowing? Tailing, tailing. Sinabing tailing, shadowing. This is the act of following a person. Pag sinusundan mo yung tao, sinusundan mo, halimbawa, may isang suspect na kilala na ninyo yung asawa niya. Yung asawa na yan, sundan mo. Okay? Para pag nasundan mo yan, baka puntahan niya yung suspect natin, yung hinahanap nating suspect. Ang tawag sa pagsunod sa kanya ay tailing or shadowing. Okay. Tailing or shadowing. There are types of tailing or shadowing. It is either loose tail, rough shadowing, or close tail. Ano yung kaibahan ng tatlo? Pag sinabing loose tail or loose tailing or loose shadowing, it is being employed if a general impression of the subject's habit and associate is required. Loose lang siya. Okay lang. Ah, nandun siya. Yan lang pala siya. Yan pala yung bahay niya. Okay, loose lang siya. Hindi mo naman kailangang sundan siya ng sundan. At least alam mo na doon siya pupunta. Yun ang bahay niya. Okay, yan ang ginagawa niya. How about yung rough shadowing? Rough na. This is done even without special precaution since the criminal is aware of the tail or shadow. Ibig sabihin, alam na sinusundan siya. Okay lang, rough shadowing lang. Sundan mo lang siya. Alam na niya sinusundan mo. At least, namomonitor mo siya. It's rough shadowing. Kahit hindi ka na mag-precaution, kilala ka na niya eh. Alam niya, sumusunod ka sa kanya. Okay. How about yung close tail? This is done with extreme precaution to avoid losing the subject. Eh, dapat mag-precaution ka. Baka mawala sa paningin mo. Okay. It involves constant surveillance. Dapat tuloy-tuloy yung pagsusurvey mo. Ang tawag dan close tail. Close tailing. Dapat hindi mawala sa paningin mo. Dapat masundan mo saan man siya pumunta. That's close tailing. Okay. Okay. So this is a question. In surveillance operation or in surveillance, this refers to the act of following a person to gather information or important information. It is the act of following a person. Nandun yung keyword. The act of following a person. Ano yan? Okay. Is it casing? Is it undercover investigation? Is it tailing or shadowing? Or is it surveillance of places? Mamili kayo. A, B, C, or D? A, B, C, or D? Is it surveillance of places? Is it tailing or shadowing? Is it undercover investigation or is it casing? Ano? Surveillance of places? Ang keyword natin dito is act of following a person. Yung susundan mo. Yung following, okay. Sundan mo, ano siya? Okay, may mga sumasagot na. Letter B. Very good. Letter B. Tailing or shadowing. Act of following. Pag sinabing tailing, yung word na tail. Sumusunod lagi yan. Okay. Yung shadowing, yung shadow mo. Okay, sumusunod lagi. Saan ka magpunta? Okay, the act of following a person. That is tailing. Tailing or shadowing. Okay. Ano yung casing? It is initial conduct of surveillance operation. Initial survey. Okay, casing. Ano yung undercover investigation? Ito yung tinatawag na roping. Ano yung undercover? You assume a fictitious identity. Nagpapanggap ka. Diba, nagpapanggap na nagtitinda ng ice cream. Nagpapanggap na nagtitinda ng kung ano-ano. Nagpapanggap na Grab driver, okay? Para lang masundan. Ano yung surveillance of places? Yan yung lugar, sinusurvey mo yung lugar. But if you are following a person just to gather information, ang tawag doon tailing or shadowing. Very good, letter B. Very good. Very good. Okay. These are the types of tailing or shadowing. By foot. Okay, by foot tayo ha, by foot. Kasi pwede yan by foot or by vehicle. By foot man muna tayo. Lumalabas sa board to. One man shadow, two man shadow, ay yung tinatawag na three man shadow. Okay. Yung one man shadow, ang keyword dyan, most common because it only involves the use of a few operatives. So one man shadow. This is the most common. Most common yan, laging ginagamit. Sundan mo, kahit mag-isa ka, susundan mo yan. Okay. Ano yung two-man shadow? Okay. One shadower will follow the subject while the other is abreast or at the opposite side of the street. Ibig sabihin, may isang sumusunod, yung isa nakaalalay. Pag mababurn out na yung sumusunod, ang papalit sa kanya, yung taong nakaalalay sa kanya. That's a two-man shadow. Ang advantage ng two-man shadow sa one-man shadow, pag na-burn out yung one-man shadow, tapos na ang laban. Yung two-man shadow, pag na-burn out yung unang sumusunod, at least mayroong alternative yung ikalawa. Okay. So, yun yung kaibahan ng dalawa. One-man shadow, two-man shadow. How about yung tinatawag na three-man shadow or ABC method? Okay. Ganun din. Same with two-man shadow, but it's more advantageous since the operative may take turns in tailing the subject which help avoid detection. So, three-man sila. Papalit-palit sila. Okay. Yung first man na sumusunod, pwede siyang magpapalit sa second man. Yung second man, pwede siyang magpapalit sa third man. Then alternately, nagpapalitan sila. Ang tawag dyan, ABC method. So mas mahirap ma-detect nung sinusundan, nung subject na may sumusunod sa kanya. Okay. Unlike sa one-man shadow, oh, kanina pa sumusunod sa akin to ah. Yan. Yung two-man shadow, kanina may sumusunod sa akin na nakapula. Ngayon may nakablue na. Kanina, andyan na naman yung nakapula. Ba't para nagpapalitan sila? Ang tawag dyan is a two-man shadow. Tailing or shadowing. Okay. Pero pag tatlo, palit-palitan, it's much better. It is much difficult to detect. That's the types of shadowing. One-man shadow, two-man shadow, at saka three-man shadow or ABC method. Okay, question. Okay. Question tayo. Get ready to answer this question. This also refers to the three-man method utilized in tailing or shadowing procedures. May mga keyword na tayo rito. Three-man method. Tatlo. Okay. Anong method daw yan? Anong method yan? Is it casing method? Is it ABC method? Is it rough method? Or is it RTC method? Okay, try to answer. Casing method or letter A? Is it ABC method? Is it rough method or RTC method? Ano siya? Okay, ang daming sumasagot. Letter B daw. B. Sabi ni Sir Corbin Lima Papa. Letter B. Okay. Sabi ni Sir Mark Adrian Umas As. Letter B. Very good. Sabi ni Sir Emil Ray Cruzado. ABC method. Titignan natin. Ah, mali. Si Sir Tatanaz. Pasensya na. Mali yan. Letter B ang tamang sagot. Not A. Bawi ka mamaya. Bawi ka. Letter B. Very good. ABC method. Very good. Ang gagaling. Very good. This is a very good group. Very good. Okay, very good. Okay. Yun yung foot tailing or foot shadowing. How about sa tinatawag na shadowing by car or automobile, by vehicle? Hindi ka maglalakad. Lalo kung ang gamit ng subject mo ay sasakyan. Anong dapat mong gamitin? Sasakyan din, sir. Okay. Ilan? O, tignan natin kung ilan. Okay. Mayroon tayong tinatawag na one car method. Okay. Pag sinabing one car, isang sasakyan. Follow at about 70 to 100 yards. Although distance may vary depending on the condition of traffic. Kung ngayon na may pandemic, maluwag, dati maluwag sa EDSA, eh huwag mo sundin yung 70 to 100 yards. Dapat, kwan ka, tignan mo, ilan lang naman kayo, sumunod ka. One car method, okay. Pero ang daling ma-detect lang yan, one car method. Bakit tong sasakyan na to, sunod ng sunod sa akin? Nag-U-turn ako kanina, dun sa Rojas Boulevard. Andiyan na naman siya. Hanggang nakarating ako ng airport, andiyan na naman. Okay. Madaling ma-detect. But if two-car method, mayroong lead car, tapos mayroong isang nakasubaybay, follow the lead car at an equal distance. Okay. The driver must change lanes whenever possible. Bakit? Para hindi sila ma-detect. Magpalitan sila. Okay. Mauna yung isa, susunod yung isa. So palit-palitan. Pwedeng overtake yung isa, maiwan yung isa. Then alternately. So two-car method. Oh, mahirap ma-detect yan. Unlike sa one-car method, madali lang yan. Mag-isa lang yung sasakyan mo. Ah. Eh, ang sasakyan pa naman, isa lang kulay, isang model. Okay. Pag napamilyar yung sinusundan mo, patay ka na. Sa two-car method, pwede kang magpalit-palit. Pag na-burn out yung una, tutuloy ng ikalawa. That's the advantage of two-car method. Okay. Mayroon tayong tinatawag na undercover investigation or roping. Ano yung undercover? Mahirap ito. Ito yung itataya muna yung buhay mo. Okay. Magpapanggap ka. Ang problema nga lang pag na-burnout ka. Okay. Undercover investigation or roping. Okay, tandaan natin. Pag sinabing undercover, same term lang yan with roping. Roping. A form of investigation in which the investigator assumes a different and unofficial identity in order to obtain information and locate the criminal. Okay. Police ka. Pwede kang magpanggap na basurero. Pwede kang magpanggap na sorbitero. Okay. You will assume a different and unofficial identity. Siyempre, pag police ka, naka-uniform ka, kilala ka. But if you will adopt or assume a different and unofficial identity, mas madaling malocate ang criminal. Okay, mas madali. Mas madali. So, tandaan ninyo, yung term na undercover investigation or roping, parehas lang yan. Okay, roping, tawag dyan. Okay, question. Okay, try to answer this question. Katatapos lang. Okay, sa mga bagong kwan lang. O sige, you try to answer this. What is the other term we use to refer to undercover investigation or undercover operation? Is it shadowing? Is it roping? Is it tailing? Is it casing? Or is it surveillance? Okay, let us try to differentiate these choices. Pag sinabing shadowing at tailing, you are following somebody, either a person or a vehicle. Shadowing, tailing. Okay. Eh yung casing, sabi natin, bago mo ikandak yung actual surveillance operation, magkakandak ka ng casing. Yun yung initial surveillance operation. Initial muna. Pero, pagka, ito na, kinandak mo na yung observation ng places, persons, vehicles, nagkakandak ka ng surveillance. Pero, if you are conducting undercover investigation, you're assuming a different identification other than your being a police officer or you being a criminal investigator, magpapanggap ka. Ang tawag dyan ay letter. Okay, very good. Letter D. Very good. Dami nakakuha. Letter D. Roping. Roping. Very good. Very good. Roping. It's not shadowing. It's not tailing. It's not casing. It's not surveillance. It is roping. So, kailangan familiar tayo sa mga terms, terminologies. This is just a matter of review. Maging familiar tayo sa mga word. Pag sinabing roping, undercover yan. Yan yung mga nagpapanggap. Yan. Undercover investigation. Okay. So, tapos na tayo. How to trace criminal. How to identify criminal. How to locate criminal. Isa na lang naiwan sa atin. How to gather evidence to prove the guilt of the suspect. I-explain natin yan. So, matatapos na natin yung third objectives ng criminal investigation. Yung third objective na yan, ito na. Okay. We will now gather evidence. Ang pag-uusapan na natin dito is evidence. Ebidensya na. Okay. Bakit? Nagkaroon na ng identification. Na-identify na natin. Okay. Nasagot na natin yung question na who? Okay.
nagkaroon na tayo ng tracing or locating. Nasaan yung criminal na yan, yung suspect na yan, nasagot na natin. Okay. Ngayon, ang next nating isosolve. Okay. Pag-usapan natin, how to gather evidence. Okay. Bakit kailangan mag-gather ng evidence? To provide evidence to prove his guilt. Okay. Tandaan natin, in criminal proceeding, the proof required, sabi nga nila, is a proof of guilt beyond reasonable doubt. Okay, sulat natin yan. Sa criminal proceeding, in criminal proceeding, okay, ang required proof ay proof of guilt beyond, tandaan nyo lagi ito, reasonable doubt. Mahirap, walang pag-aalinlangan na itong suspect na to, guilty siya, yan, sa criminal proceeding. Nakaiba sa ibang proceeding. Pag sa civil proceeding, ano lang kailangan? Sa civil, ano? Kung sa criminal ay proof of guilt beyond reasonable doubt, sa civil, ang kailangan lang natin ay yung tinatawag na preponderance of evidence. Yan. Yan ang kailangan natin. Preponderance of evidence. Sir, paano sa administrative? Admin. Administrative proceeding. Anong kailangan nating proof? Ang kailangan nating proof, ay yung tinatawag na substantial evidence. Okay. So, ang hirap para sa isang investigador na ang kukunin mong ebidensya ay para maka-arrive tayo rito sa tinatawag na proof of guilt beyond reasonable doubt. Bakit kailangan ng proof of guilt beyond reasonable doubt? Bakit? Bakit pag hindi tayo nakakuha ng ebidensya na ang amount nito is a proof of guilt beyond reasonable doubt, ano mangyari sa ating kaso? Ano mangyari sa ating kaso? Hindi mag-prosper. Okay. Sa prosecution pillar pa lang, kung kulang yung ebidensya at hindi nagtrabaho yung criminal investigator, dismiss. Okay. Assuming na iakyat ang kaso sa korte, pagdating sa korte, pag hindi enough yung ebidensya, okay, kulang, lacking ng tamang ebidensya, dahil itong investigator hindi nagtrabaho ng maayos, okay, anong mangyayari? Either ma-dismiss yung kaso or ma-acquit yung akusado. Sayang. Pero pag nagtrabaho ng maayos itong investigador, gamit yung knowledge niya as a CI, criminal investigator, pag ginamit niya yan ng tama, makakakuha siya ng ebidensya. What kind of evidence? An evidence that must be admissible. Okay. Kailan mo masasabing admissible yung evidence na yan? Pag ito ay relevant and competent. Okay. It must be relevant, it must be competent evidence. it is an evidence that is not excluded by law. Okay. Relevant evidence that has connection doon sa krimen. If it is relevant, it is competent, it is admissible as an evidence to prove the guilt of the accused. So napaka-importante yung trabaho ng criminal investigator. So ulitin ko yung preliminaries natin kanina. Ang trabaho ng criminal investigator ay napaka-importante. At kailangan pag ginawa niya yan, mayroon siyang, ulitin natin, mayroon siyang, okay. Legal, mayroon siyang technical, at mayroon siyang tactical skills and knowledge. Okay. Ito ang dapat nasa isang investigador, magaling na investigador. Legal. Mayroon siyang legal knowledge. Knowledge on criminal law. Knowledge on criminal procedure. Knowledge on criminal evidence. Yan. Okay. Yun yung legal knowledge. How about technical? Sabi natin, instrumentation. The third eye in criminal investigation. Dapat marunong siya ng criminalistics. Marunong siyang mag-lift ng latent fingerprint. Marunong siyang mag-operate ng polygraph machine. Marunong siyang mag-analyze ng question document. Okay. How about tactical? Ang trabaho ng pulis o investigador, napakahirap. Habang ginagawa mo yung trabaho mo, dapat nakahanda ka at anytime na sa panganib ng buhay mo. Okay, dapat marunong kang bumaril. Marunong kang sumuntok. Okay, marunong ka ng unarmed self-defense. Ganyan dapat ang investigador. Okay, para gamitin mo na lahat ito, itong legal, technical, tactical, para ma-attain mo yung objectives. Okay, objectives ng CI, criminal investigation. Ano? Identification. Number two, location. Number three, providing of evidence. Identification of the suspect. Location of the suspect. And you are providing, yun na nga, evidence. Okay? What kind of evidence? Evidence that is admissible. Kailan maging admissible? If it is relevant, it is competent. So, nakuha ninyo? Okay. So, this is just the first wave of our lecture. Medyo pagod na ako. At alam ko, medyo inaantok na rin kayo. So, next time, magpapa-schedule dito ako kay Attorney Ferraro. Okay? Itutuloy natin yan para maramdaman ninyo gaano kaganda mag-aral ng criminal investigation. Okay? At gaano ka-importante yung mga knowledge and skills na nakuha ninyo bilang criminology student pag kayo ay naging investigador balang araw. Okay? Napakasarap makasolve ng isang kaso. Bakit? Habang nakakasolve ka ng kaso, nagkakaroon ka ng fulfillment sa'yo. Ha? Tunay nga, pulis ako. Tunay nga, criminologist ako. So, para maging sa mga hindi pa criminologist, mag-review kayo. Huwag niyong tigilan ang pagbabasa. Okay? Basa kayo ng basa para at least hindi mawala sa inyo yung pinag-aralan nyo. Then next year, mag-exam kayo. Kung kailan man na i-open ulit ng PRC, yung examination, kasi postpone nata ditong November. Kailangan makapasa kayo. And you will apply your knowledge and skills as a criminologist pagdating ng araw. So, nice meeting you. We will continue with our discussion next week, any other time na ibigay sa akin ni Attorney Jay Peraro. Attorney, thank you so much and good evening sa ating mga reviewers. Kamisay. Thank you so much. See you again next time. Thank you.